Hello children, let us start with exercise 8.2. Here you are learning about finding the area between the curves. You already learned about this concept in our introductory videos. I am not going to teach anything new. Just let us quickly revise and start with the problems. So here they are giving you a curve. Let us take one curve. I am drawing above x-axis, means when y is positive. Okay. Asking you, let us take, they are asking you to find the area bounded by the curve with the x-axis between the limits. Let us take x is equal to a and x equal to b. Nothing but asking you to find the area of this shaded part. You learned that this area you can find it as integral of y dx and the limits are from a to b. Okay. If they ask you find the area bounded by the curve with the y-axis, you between the limits, let me take y is equal to some c to d, then they are asking you to find the area of this. Let us denote it as this as a1 and this as a2, and you learned this is equal to integral x dy, and you will write y limits. Okay, means y is varying from c to d. So, when the area bounded by the curve with the x-axis, y dx and right x limits, bounded by the curve with the y-axis, you have to write x dy and write y limits. Now, this is when one curve is given. Suppose they are giving you two curves. Let us take one is y is equal to f of x and another one is, let us take it is y is equal to g of x. Asking you to find the area between the curves. Let us take between the limits x is equal to a and x is equal to b. Okay, then you learned that this area between the curves, okay, this one, you can write it as difference of two areas. Let us denote it as a1 and a2, where your a1 is nothing but the area bounded by the upper curve with the x-axis between the limits x equal to a and x equal to b. Nothing but this is the area we are denoting with a1. Okay. That is nothing but with the x-axis. So we have to write y dx and this is y of the upper curve. Nothing but y of f dx between the limits a to b. And we will write x limits minus A2. A2 is nothing but the area bounded by the lower curve, okay, with the x-axis between the limits x equal to a and x equal to b. So, the area is something like this. This is your A2. So, A2 is equal to, it is with the x-axis. So, again y dx. So, it is y of the lower curve, that is nothing but g dx, and write the x limits. Okay, so this one you can actually simplify and write it as this is equal to integral. Same limits are there. So, x is varying from a to b, y of f minus y of g into dx. That is y of the upper curve minus y of the lower curve. Okay, so this a1 is the entire area minus A2, means this is your A2. If I subtract this A2, you get your required area. The concept is, what is that? Tell me. Here you will write it as y of the upper curve minus y of the lower curve between the limits x is from a to b. You will write when you are finding the area with respect to x-axis. Now let us take one example and see quickly what happens if it is with respect to y-axis. So let us take two curves, let me draw and name this as, this is y equal to f of x and this is y equal to g of x. Let us take this. Okay. And let us find the area bounded between the curves. So, first to draw, you have to draw the curves. Second, identify the area between them. So, area between is nothing but a part of the region which is having boundaries as these two curves. Okay. So, this is nothing but the area. Okay. Now, if we are finding, as we find here, area bounded by the curve with the x-axis, then as I told you, it is upper minus lower. So that, now what is the upper curve? Upper curve is nothing but y y is equal to f of x. So the required area is again upper area minus the lower area. You will write that is nothing but integral of upper is nothing but y of f minus the lower curve, that is nothing but y of g. Okay, this is y dx because we are considering, okay, with the x-axis. Between the limits, let me write the points of intersection as some here anyway origin. Here I took it as a to b. So the limits are here. X is varying from 0 to, this is nothing but x is a line. So the limits are from 0 to a, and you will write the x limits. That is when you are arguing or when you are seeing the finding the area bounded with respect to the x-axis. Now the same concept, let us find the area between the curves, but instead of with respect to x-axis, let us take with respect to y-axis. Okay, so there we will draw a line. Let me take, this is nothing but the y-coordinate, so y equal to b. Okay, and we will again apply the same concept, the upper minus lower. So here when you see that this is your upper curve, okay, means this one you turn it and see, this one y axis you make it as x axis and see, so that this is your upper curve, okay, and this one will be the lower curve. So the area bounded by the upper curve with the y axis minus the area bounded by the lower curve with the y axis. This is your area bounded by the lower curve. This one we will subtract from the entire part. Okay, from this entire part, subtract this. Okay, so this is again upper minus lower. Now what is your upper curve? It is the y equal to g of x is the upper curve, but I am writing it with respect to y, so I have to write x dy. So I will write from this one, I will find out what is the x value. X is equal to something we will write, and I will say it as x of the upper curve, upper curve is g, minus x of the upper curve is g minus x of the lower curve. Okay, that is lower curve is f into this is x dy you will write, and you will write the y limits. Y is varying from 0 to b. Okay, so here one more concept I'll tell you. Sometimes what they see about as they, instead of taking with respect to x-axis or with respect to y-axis, instead of that sometimes it is considered as with respect to x-axis, they take it as the vertical strip. Okay, they take it as the vertical strip. This vertical strip most starts from here. Okay, when it starts exactly here, it becomes a point, and this vertical strip slowly moves. As it is moving, its length increases, and slowly when it reaches its length again becomes zero. So this is your vertical strip. Vertical strip area, if you take, okay, very thin strip you take, you learn this logic when you are learning about the limit of a sum and all. Okay, you take a very thin strip, so the length we will take it as some y, and breadth we will take it as dx, so that area of this vertical strip is nothing but y dx, that is nothing but y dx. Okay, so here the vertical strip is moving from 0 to a. Vertical strip starts here as a point, slowly it moves, increases its length, and slowly goes till here till b. Okay, as the strip is moving from here to here, okay, it covers the area. So there also they will write the vertical strip, the length is nothing but again upper minus lower, this is the upper curve minus lower curve. When you write y dx, or if you want to write x dy, instead of the vertical strip, they will consider the horizontal strip. Okay, let us consider one horizontal strip. So horizontal strip, when you consider, the length they will take it as x, and the breadth they will take it as dy. So that the area of that strip will be x dy with respect to y axis. Both the concepts are same. Whichever you feel comfortable, you can start learning in that way. So we will be telling you in both the ways. Okay, mainly concept is based on one thing. It is always the upper curve minus the lower curve when it is finding the area between the curves. Whenever this y dx it comes, sometimes we will talk about the vertical strip. Okay, and x dy when it is coming, we will talk about horizontal strip. both are one and the same. Whichever you feel comfortable, you can follow that. Mainly, we will explain the problem in terms of this, okay? Rather than this, we will do the problems in terms of this. So, what I am telling here, when you are, once again, I am revising, okay? When it is the area bounded by the between the curves with respect to the x-axis you take, then it is y dx upper minus lower. With respect to the y-axis if you take, it is x dy, again upper minus lower. Usually, many times, this upper curve here becomes the lower curve and this lower curve becomes the upper curve. Okay, so one more thing before going to the next point, please understand that this upper minus lower concept will not be valid always. Okay. Now, the extra point I wanted you to observe here is that when the curves are not intersecting between the given limits, then your logic of upper minus lower works. If they are intersecting between the given limits, let me draw an example. When x is equal to a and x equal to b are the two given limits, between the given limits, if your curve is, both the curves are intersecting like this, maybe at some point x equal to c. Okay, this is the first curve f of x and this is the g of x. Then between these two limits, you cannot say upper minus lower because your function for a while it becomes an upper curve, but afterwards it becomes a lower curve. Then you have to break it and write depending upon the given problem you will conclude. Okay, and whenever your area, maybe a part of the area is above x-axis, part of the area is below x-axis, something like this, between the limits x is equal to a and x is equal to b. Okay, if something like this is there also, no problem, it is always upper minus lower. Okay, with respect to the y-axis also, let us take this is the area they are asking you, between the limits y is equal to some c to y equal to some d. If this is the area they are asking, a part of the area is in the negative x-axis, okay, then also no problem, you can start with your logic of upper minus lower. Okay, this one you already learned in your introductory videos. And also, when you are finding the area between the curves, you should know about the symmetry. Okay, when the equation y is equal to f of x is having all the powers of x, all the powers of x are even. When the powers of x are even, then the graph is symmetrical about y-axis. Okay, something like this. This is symmetrical about y-axis. Y is equal to x square. All the powers of x are even, then it is symmetrical about y-axis. All the powers of y are even, something like y square is equal to x, then it is symmetrical about x-axis. Your circle, which is both, let me write x square plus y square is equal to some a square. All the powers of x are even, so that it is symmetrical about both the coordinate axis. And also the even function, even functions are always symmetrical about the y-axis. Odd functions are symmetrical about the origin. It means the graph of the odd function, something like if you take y is equal to x square graph, okay, your y equal to x cube, sorry, y equal to x cube. In the opposite quadrants, your graph will be symmetrical. Okay, so when you are talking about the area between the curves, so you have to think about the symmetricity of the given curve about the coordinate axis, or sometimes you can have a symmetricity about a line. Okay, let me take a parabola, okay, some shifted parabola, let us take about some line x is equal to some a. Okay, it is having a vertex as some a comma b, then this parabola is symmetrical about the line x equal to a, nothing but to the left of the line x equal to a, whatever the shape is there, the same shape is there to the right, that is nothing but the symmetry. Okay, symmetrical about y-axis means to the right of y-axis, whatever the shape is there, to the left of y-axis also the same shape, above the x-axis whatever the shape is there, below the x-axis also the same shape. This is symmetrical about y-axis, symmetrical about x-axis, symmetrical about the both the coordinate axis, symmetrical in the opposite quadrants. Whenever an odd function is there, your sin x, tan x, they are all symmetrical in the opposite quadrants. Okay, and this one, if you take it is symmetrical about a line. This symmetricity also, you should have an idea to talk about the area between the curves. Anyway, now let us start with our problems. Let us solve the first problem of exercise 8.2. Find the area of the circle which is interior to the parabola. So the given two curves here are, one is a circle and another one is parabola. First let us draw the two curves. The circle equation I will write like this. X square plus y square is equal to 4, you take out common, bring it to this side, 9 by 4 is nothing but 3 by 2 whole square. Nothing but it is a circle with the center as origin and radius as 3 by 2. Something like this. Okay. This is 3 by 2 comma 0. Cuts the x and y axis at the 3 by 2. Next one is x square equal to 4y, which is nothing but an upward parabola. Let us draw both the curves. First job is done. Now let us plot the area they are asking. Asking you to find area of the circle which is interior to the parabola, means interior is nothing but inside the parabola. This one entire thing is area of the circle. They want area which is inside the parabola, nothing but this one, the area of the circle which is lying inside the parabola. Okay, so the second job is done. We have plotted the area that they are asking. Now, before going further for finding, first let us find the points of intersection. They are intersecting at A and B. So, first let me solve these two equations. So, 4, wherever x square is there, I substitute 4y. That is nothing but we are solving these two equations. Substituting this inside this, which is a quadratic in y. Okay, minus 36, 16 you want. So that it is 18 and minus 2. So 4y square plus 18y minus 2y minus 9 equal to 0. You can take here 2y common. So that it is, what we are doing is solving the given two curves so that we can obtain the points of intersection. We got y is plus half r, it is minus 9 by 2. Okay. If you observe, these two curves are not intersecting when y is negative. So, discard this value. Take only this. When y equal to half, means y coordinate is half, what is the x coordinate? Let us find. So, substitute y either here or here. It is easy in the parabola. So, x square equal to 4 into, I substitute y equal to half, so that x is plus or minus root 2. So, what are the point? How many points of intersection? Two points of intersection, which is plus root 2 comma half. Another one is minus root 2 comma half. So, we obtain the points of intersection. Now, the next one. We have to see how to find the area of the given this one, plotted one. Okay. So, here two things you observe. This one, the circle is symmetrical about both x and y axis. And the parabola is symmetrical about y-axis. Means, whenever the powers of x are even, it is symmetrical about y-axis. Whenever the powers of y are even, symmetric about x-axis. So, here both the curves are symmetrical about y-axis. Nothing but, whatever the area that you are having on one side of the y-axis, if you take this one, the same area will be there here. So, if this is 5, this is also 5, so total is 10, 10 square units. So, instead of finding the entire area, we will find the area of this one, that is OA. Let me name it as some C, O. Okay, so this is the area, let us find. Then the total area is equal to 2 times the area of the given one. So, the required area is equal to, we can write it as 2 times the area of this one, OACO. Okay. So, how to find the area of this? Either you can go with the vertical strip or the horizontal strip. I will explain by taking the vertical strip. Usually, we will take the vertical strip. Okay. Let us take, this is the vertical strip. This vertical strip is moving from x equal to 0 to x is equal to root 2. Okay. This is the line x equal to root 2. So, it is moving from 0 to root 2, covering the given required area. Okay. So, when you take the first one, when you take the upper part, you get the area of this. Minus, when you take the area of the parabola. Okay. This one, if you take, when you take this one, This is the upper part and this is the lower part. When you write upper minus lower, you get your required one. Upper one is this entire area, lower one is only this. When you write upper minus lower, you get your required area. It is always the upper curve minus lower curve gives you the area between the curves. So that we will write this is equal to 2 times of, okay, the upper one is the circle, lower one is the parabola. So it is y, we are taking the vertical strip, so that it is y dx. So it is y of the circle minus y of the parabola, okay, y dx. And what are the limits? I have to write the limits for x. X is varying from 0 to root 2. Okay, so that is nothing but, now let us write 2 times of the integration 0 to root 2. Now what is y from here? From the circle, your y is equal to square root of 3 by 2 whole square minus x square. Plus or minus you get, the upper part will be with a plus square root of 3 by 2 whole square minus x square, means the upper circle. The lower circle, this one is minus square root of 3 by 2 whole square minus x square. Anyway, we are considering the upper part, this part. So I took the plus 1, okay, y of the circle minus y of the parabola. Parabola y is nothing but x square by 4, okay, dx. Now we are left with doing the integration of this. Okay, so this is equal to, let me write 2 times of integration. It is a square minus x square. So it is x by 2 into square root of a square minus x square. Okay, plus a square by 2, that is 3 by 2 whole square, 9 by 4 by 2 into sine inverse of x by a, that is x by 3 by 2. Okay, first part integration is done, minus this one, x square integration is x cube by 3, 3 into 4 nothing but 12. Okay, so limits are from 0 to root 2. Now let us substitute the limits and finish the problem. So if I write 2 times of, substitute root 2, first we can actually cancel 2 here. Let me cancel 2, here also if I cancel 2 it becomes a 6. Okay, so that, now substitute x equal to root 2 upper limit. So it is root 2 into, it is nothing but 9 by 4, okay, 9 by 4 minus 2, root 2 whole square under root, okay, my plus, it is 9 by 4 into sine inverse of root 2 by 3 by 2, upper limit. Here if I substitute root 2, it becomes root 2 whole cube, so that it is 2 root 2 by 6. If I substitute the lower limit 0, x is here, if I substitute 0, 0 into anything is 0, sine inverse of 0 is 0, so here also x is there, so 0. Lower limit is vanishing. So now let us simplify the final answer. So this is nothing but, if I write this is 9 minus 8, it is 1 by 4, that is nothing but root 2 into 1 by 4 under root, so it is 2, plus it is 9 by 4 sine inverse root 2 by 3 by 2, so that 2 root 2 by 3, okay, minus, cancel this, so it is minus root 2 by 3, so that your required area A is equal to, let me write 9 by 4 sine inverse 2 root 2 by 3 minus root 2, if you take out common, half minus 1 by 3, so that it is 1 by 6, so root 2 by 6, which is actually with a plus sign, okay, square units, don't forget to write square units. This is the area of the required shaded part. So the first thing is plot the curves, first thing. Second thing, what is the required area you observe, and then find the points of intersection and you decide which is you are taking, either the vertical strip or the horizontal strip. If it is the vertical strip, it is upper minus lower. Always the concept is upper minus lower. So upper is the circle, lower is the parabola. So vertical strip means it is y dx. Okay. And write what is y from both the curves, integrate to get the answer. Let us see the second problem. Find the area bounded by x minus 1 whole square plus y square equal to 1 and x square plus y square equal to 1. Both are circles. Let us name it as C1 and this is the circle C2. And both are having the radii as 1. This one with the center as origin and the second circle with the center as 1, 0. So the first jump, draw both the curves. So first let us see the first curve with the center as origin and radius as 1 unit. This is the first curve. So cuts the x-axis at 1, 0 and y-axis at 0, 1. This is your C1. Next C2, center as 1, 0. Radius as 1 unit means 1 unit this side cuts the x-axis at origin and 1 unit this side. So cuts the x-axis at 2, 0. Radius as 1 unit, so somewhere here. So let me draw the second circle. Okay, this is your second circle. Okay, now we have drawn both the circles. Before going further, let us see the points of intersection of these two. What is your point of intersection? So for that, let us solve both the curves. Consider the first one, second one, that is I am writing it as x square plus y square minus 2x plus 1. Means I am expanding and writing. In this, the second circle, substitute the first circle. That is nothing but x square plus y square is 1 minus 2x plus 1 equal to 0. Sorry, equal to 1. So 1 gets cancelled. X is equal to 1 by 2. So they both are intersecting at x is equal to 1/2. We don't need y coordinate because we will take the vertical strip, means we need the x limits. So y coordinate of a and b, I am taking it as some y1 and y2, you can get by substituting also. Okay, now we have obtained the points of intersection of these two curves. Now let us see what is the area they are asking. The area bounded by C1 and C2 means area between these two curves. The area between these two curves is nothing but this one. This is the area they are asking you to find. Okay. Now how to find the area? So for that, here you have to observe few things. The first thing is both the circles are having the radii as 1. Okay, and the center as 1, 0, 0, 1. Nothing but both the centers are lying on the same line with the equal radii. Okay, maybe my figure is not that perfect, with the equal radii. So what happens with this point is, by observing this, that radii are equal and center lying on the same line, which is nothing but x-axis, what you get is, when you are C1, okay, when you move along x-axis by one unit, you get C2. When C1 is moved along x-axis by 1 unit, you get C2. So, with that, the curve area, whatever the curve that you are getting here, this curve equation is same as this curve equation. That is the first thing. Second thing, both the curves, okay, both the curves are having even power in y. Even power in y gives you symmetricity about x-axis. Now, what is meant by symmetricity about x-axis? The area above x-axis, this one, will be equal to the area below x-axis. That is the symmetricity about x-axis. Area above x-axis same as the area below x-axis. That is the second thing. Okay, third one. When you see that these two points are intersecting along the line x equal to 1/2. This is the line x equal to 1/2. Okay, if you take this one is x is equal to 1/2. Let me remove this anyway, I don't need. This is the line x equal to 1/2. As your circle C1 is moved by 1 unit along x-axis to get the circle C2. As this is the point we observed, with that observation, I can say that the area which is lying to the left of the line x equal to 1/2. The area which is lying to the left of the line x equal to 1/2. This area will be equal to the area which is lying on the right side of the line x equal to 1/2. This area is equal to this area. Means two things. The area above x-axis is same as the area below x-axis.
the area which is to the left of the line x equal to half is equal to the area which is on the right of the line x equal to half gives you the final conclusion that this area can be divided into four equal parts. This is the first part, this is the second one, third one, fourth one. Okay, so your required area is the total shaded area. I can write that your required area is equal to 4 times of the area obtained. Let me denote it as O. This is A and let me take it as C. So this is OAC. Area OAC. Let me go back to OACO. The total area is now can be divided into 4 equal parts. So 4 times of one part is equal to your total required area. Now our duty is to find the area of this part. Okay, so the for that one, this is the area we will find. So for that we will consider the vertical strip. Let me consider the vertical strip. Whenever it is a vertical strip, your problem is, what is that, tell me? It is, whenever you are writing the vertical strip, it will be y dx. Okay, now what is that curve that we are taking? This is the curve we are taking. This curve is for what? For the circle C2. So this is y of C2. And my vertical strip starts at x equal to 0 and it moves through x equal to 0 and till x equal to half. So that this vertical strip covers your total area. So it is x equal to 0 to x equal to half. Y of C2 dx. This is your 4 times of this is your required area. So everything we have done, only thing is now I'll write what is Y of C2. So C2 is this, Y square is equal to 1 minus of this. So Y is equal to, you can write it as integral X is anywhere 0 to 1 by 2. Okay. Your Y is nothing but square root of 1 minus X minus 1 whole square. Yes. Okay, so if you take this upper part will be with the plus square root, the lower part will be with the minus square root. I need an upper part, so I took the plus square root. So everything is done, we have to now integrate. Okay, now we will write the integration of this. It is nothing but a square minus x square. Instead of x, you are having ax plus b, where a is equal to 1, b is minus 1. Okay, so let me finish the problem by writing the integration. So it is 4 times of integral a square minus x square. So formula is x by 2. Instead of x, you are having x minus 1. X by 2, that is x minus 1 by 2 into square root of 1 square minus x minus 1 whole square. Okay, let me remove this because it will be maybe a little confusion. This is limits are from 0 to half. This one integration I am writing, it is x by 2, that is x minus 1 by 2 into a square minus x square plus a square, that is 1 by 2 into sine inverse x by a, that is x minus 1 by a is 1 and the limits are from 0 to half. Okay, now let us finish the problem by substituting the limits. So for that, the required area is a is equal to 4 times of, let us substitute the limits. When I substitute x equal to half, half minus 1, that is nothing but minus 1 by 2 by 2 into square root of 1 minus half whole minus 1 minus half whole square is 1 by 4. Okay, plus this is 1 by 2 into sine inverse of half minus 1, that is sine inverse minus 1, sorry, minus half. Okay, this is the upper limit minus, let us write the lower limit. When I substitute the lower limit, x is equal to 0 when I substitute, so that it is 0 minus 1 is minus 1 by 2. Okay, 0 minus 1 whole square is 1 square, 1 minus 1, 0. So minus 1 by 2 into 0, nothing but 0, it vanishes. Okay, plus this is 1 by 2 into substitute x equal to 0, sine inverse minus 1. Okay, now this is your total area, the final answer. Let me write it. Now let me simplify this. This is equal to, you can actually, here 2 gets cancelled, here also 2 gets cancelled, 2 gets cancelled, so that it will remain with 2 times of it is 4 minus 1. So minus 1 by 2 into 3 by under root comes, and 4 is under the root, so comes out as 2. Sin inverse minus half is minus 5 by 6 minus sin inverse minus 1 is minus 5 by 2. Okay, so that it is plus 5 by 2 minus 5 by 6. That is nothing but you can write it as 2 times of 90 minus 30. So that it is 60 minus 1 minus, this is nothing but sorry, root 3 by 4. So the final answer what you get is 2, if you can take it inside, the final answer is 2 pi by 3 minus 2 gets cancelled, root 3 by 2 square units. Okay, so before closing the problem, once again I'll tell, your circle C1 and C2 both are having same radii with the center lying on the x-axis. With that, your C1, when it is moved 1 unit along x-axis, you get C2. So the curve, whatever that you are getting here, this curve equation is equal to this curve equation. And both are having even powers for y, nothing but it is symmetrical about x-axis. The area above x-axis is equal to the area below x-axis. And the line x equal to half divides the area into two equal parts. So the total area, if you consider like this, it will be divided into four equal parts. So we are finding the area of one part. Okay, so we started with 4 times the area of this, nothing but the curve, and we found the integration. Let us see the third problem. Find the area bounded by y equal to x square plus 2, y equal to x, x equal to 0 and x equal to 3. Okay, if you see this one, y equal to x square is an upward parabola. Everybody knew this. What they are giving is, for y equal to x square, they are adding plus 2. Means y is increased by 2 units. So this parabola will be shifted along y axis by 2 units. So that you get a parabola with a vertex as 0, 2. This is your y is equal to x square plus 2. Okay. Now, before drawing the given curves, let us see whether these two are having any point of intersection or not. Means let us solve these two. So, y is equal to x square plus 2. In that, substitute y equal to x. So, you get it as a quadratic in x. X square minus x plus 2 equal to 0. If you find the discriminant, b square minus 4ac, that is minus 1 whole square is minus 1 minus 8. That is nothing but minus 7. The discriminant is negative. So, that the curves are not having any real roots. Nothing but they won't intersect on the real plane. Okay, so these two are not having any point of intersection. So with that thought, now let us plot the curves and see what is the area bounded by it. So for that, now first let us take the upward parabola shifted 2 units along y axis. So this is your y is equal to x square plus 2, and then y is equal to x, a line passing through origin. So this is your y is equal to x. Next, x equal to 0, nothing but your y axis, and x equal to 3, a line parallel to y axis. This is your x equal to 3. Now the area bounded by the parabola and the line y is equal to x between the lines x equal to 0 and x equal to 3. So the parabola x equal to 3, the line y is equal to x, and x equal to 0. That is nothing but this is the area bounded between the curves. They are asking you to find the area of this. Okay. Now how to find the area of this? We will consider the vertical strip. So consider the vertical strip. This vertical strip is moving from x is equal to 0 to x equal to 3. This is x equal to 0, origin if you want. This is nothing but 0, 2. Okay. This is x equal to 3. So, x coordinate is 3 here. Y coordinate anyway we don't want. Okay. But anyway, this is on the line y equal to x, so 3. And here, this is x equal to 3, intersection of a parabola and a line. So, 9 plus 2, so 11. Anyway, we don't need, but easy to find. So, I have found out. So, now to find the area, first one is the area of the upper curve. This one, the area bounded by the parabola between the limits x equal to 0 to x equal to 3. From that, if I subtract the area bounded by the line y equal to x between the limits x equal to 0 to 3, means this triangle area, if I subtract from the total area, you get your required area. Okay, or else you can take it is the upper curve minus the lower curve. Always the area bounded between the curves is the upper curve minus lower curve. So your area, the required area is equal to, you will write, it is nothing but the area bounded by the parabola minus the area bounded by the line, upper minus lower vertical strip. So you will write y dx. So your y is equal to y of the upper one, that is nothing but y of the parabola minus the next one, y of the line. Y of the line, y of the parabola into y of the line, dx. Upper minus lower. Okay. Now what are the limits? The limits are from x equal to 0 to x equal to 3. X equal to 0 to x equal to 3. Okay, now from the parabola, I have to write y value. Y is equal to x square plus 2. So that it is integral of x square plus 2, y of the parabola minus y of the line. The line is y is equal to x. So this is x. Okay, you are integrating with respect to x between the limits 0 to 3. Now finish the problem by doing the integration. So it is x cube by 3 plus 2x minus x squared by 2 between the limits 0 to 3. So that it is 27 by 3. So 9 plus 6 upper limit, that is 6, 9 by 2. Okay. Lower limit, if I substitute, this is the upper limit, lower limit. So everywhere x is there. So 0. So that it is 15 minus 9 by 2. 30 minus 9 is 21 by 2 square limits. Okay. So you have to here observe one thing, that these two, parabola and the line, are not having any point of intersection. We have observed that the discriminant is negative, so no real roots, so they will not intersect. And then one more thing you have to remember, whenever it is the area between the curves, it is the upper curve minus the lower curve. Okay, the area bounded by the upper curve minus the area bounded by the lower curve will give you the required area. This total minus this gives you this. That only we write. Y of the upper curve minus y of the lower curve. Vertical strip we are considering. So y dx. Write the curve equation, integrate, find the answer.